Is UniFi Dream Machine still worth it? Or you better search for alternatives. Released in late 2019, UniFi Dream Machine is an all-in-one device that combines multiple network components into one package, and it doesn't look like a router at all. But actually, it is exactly that. And yes, is it still expensive? In this video, you can expect to see my honest opinion about the UDM, and if you decide to buy such device, I will show you how I managed to set up my home network for smart home in mind. In other words, using different VLANs and rules so my IoT devices will stay separated from my main network, and if needed, only access to my home assistant server is allowed. But first, here is my story short. I had a UniFi Dream Machine for a year and a half, but now it is officially dead. No LEDs, no factory reset, only fans are working. I still don't know what happened. Probably some kind of electric shock or something. But I have to admit here, Ubiquiti support is superb. I was able to live chat with their representative in a matter of 5 minutes. The guy on the other side asked me to try some stuff, but when he realized that my UDM is really dead, he recommended to submit a RMA. Anyways, to recover my local network, I needed another Dream Machine. But then, my heart skipped a beat when I saw a new device, a Dream Machine successor, called UniFi Dream Router. This new device is Wi-Fi 6 capable with PoE ports, and it is 3 times cheaper than the Dream Machine. Soon after, my excitement went to the recycle bin, as I understood that the UniFi Dream Router was released only as early access. It was completely sold out with no ETA. That means I missed that train, unfortunately. By the way, if you are lucky enough and you managed to buy a Dream Router, leave your words in the comment section below. What is your honest opinion? Are you happy with that device or not? Fast forward, I sent my old UDM for replacement, and I ordered and received a brand new one. So if everything is successful with my RMI request, I will have 2 Dream Machines, and at the moment, I'm not sure what will I do with them. Anyways, because I had no backup of my network configuration, I had to set up everything from scratch. This time, I decided to use not the old classical view, but the UniFi brand new user interface. What can I say here? It feels like I have a totally new device. Everything looks different, but it is nice, and I even have a cloud backup option now, in case Dream Machine burns again. I must say that for the network configuration, I used the slightly modified instructions provided by the hookup for his UDM Pro device. He explains everything in great details, so all the credits for the following part goes to him. I just translated his work from UDM Pro to the regular UDM, as there are some minor differences, but the essentials are exactly the same. The first thing that I did was to create 4 more networks. So I'm now having 5 different networks in total. The process of network creation is stupid simple. You just have to go to Settings, Networks, Add New Network. This is my main LAN network, which have no VLAN assigned on purpose, and my desktop computers, laptops, tablets, phones, and so on are going to be connected there. Then I created an IoT network dedicated to all of my IoT devices that requires internet access to operate. Example of these are devices like Amazon Echo, Apple TV, Aquara, Tuya, Switchbot, and so on. All of these devices will have no access to my main network, but I will be able to access them if I want to. After that, I created a NOT network. NOT stands for Network of Things. And again, all the credits for the clever name going to hookup. In this network, I'll connect all of my IoT devices that doesn't need internet connection to operate. For example, these are all of my Tasmota, ESP32 and Arduino devices. They only need access to my home assistant servers. Then I created a family network, on which I'll have content filtering enabled, so most of the adult and malicious domains will be blocked, making this network perfect for kids. I also disabled the IGMP spoofing for all of the networks from the advanced section. I enabled the multicast DNS option from the advanced gateway settings. And last but not least, I created a VPN network with different subnet. Here is how I managed to set up the VPN. In settings, under networks, I'll add new network, I'll name it VPN, I'll expand this, I'll select advanced, remote access, the VPN protocol should be L2TP, this is a pre-shared secret key, and I'll copy this, this is auto-generated, but it is secure enough, I think. I'll create a new radius user by clicking here. Username will be smash with the password the like that. Create user. I'll not save any passwords. In advanced section, I will only change the subnet, as I don't like the suggested one visually. Of course, you can leave it that way, it doesn't matter actually. And with that, my dear friends, I think I'm ready here, and I can happily click on the Add Network button. On iOS, I'll go to Settings, VPN, add VPN configuration, I'll change the type to L2TP, as description I'll type UniFi VPN, but you can type whatever you wish. In the server field, I'll type my real static IP or my dynamic DNS hostname. This is important. Under account, I'll enter my radius username, in this case it's smash, exactly as I define it in UniFi controller. For password, I'll type my radius password, and under secret, I'll paste my pre-shared key, and I'll hit done. Then I'll select the UniFi VPN and I'll try to connect. Connected, great. I'll test this with my home assistant. As you can see, I'm using 4G, mobile data, and I'm able to open my local home assistant address using the UniFi VPN, which is perfect. I'm now ready with the basics and I can move to the Wi-Fi section. In this section, I created 4 different Wi-Fi spots and I assigned the already defined networks to them. For example, I created a Wi-Fi network named A and I selected the main LAN network here. In advanced section, I disabled the Optimize IoT Wi-Fi connectivity option and I enabled UA PSD, Multicast Enhancement, BSS transition and fast roaming. I did exactly the same for my family network. The only differences here are the name, password and the selected network, which is family in my case. For my IoT network, I enabled the Optimize IoT Wi-Fi connectivity option and I disabled everything else except for the UA PSD and multicast enhancement. Similarly, for the NOT network, I enabled the Optimize IoT Wi-Fi connectivity option, but this time I enabled only multicast enhancement, as I don't have any battery powered devices in this network. Now, when I have all my networks sliced as pizza, it is time to define some rules which will say who can eat what. I can do that with several firewall rules. From Traffic and Security menu, Global Threat Management, I enabled Detect and Block Intrusions and I set the system sensitivity to balanced. Of course, you can choose otherwise and you should decide for yourself, do you need to detect and block intrusions or to only detect them or to do nothing. Keep in mind that if you enable Detect and Block Intrusions options, your network throughput can be reduced. I can recommend to enable these options and to test your network speed. If everything is fine, leave it on. Otherwise, fine-tune it or disable it completely. Moving forward, in the exact same section, the firewall options are located. Luckily, managing the firewall rules in UniFi controllers is very easy. To allow established and related session, I created a new rule from type LAN-IN, I added a description, enabled the rule, leave the before predefined rules, action is accept, source and destination I leave to any addresses or port group, and the advanced section I enable the match state established and match state related options. This rule makes possible for the connected devices to answer when other devices in different VLANs are requesting something from them. I allowed NTP port for all of my devices in all of my networks with this rule. NTP stands for Network Time Protocol, and it is used to sync the time. The default port is 123 UDP. Next are two important firewall rules that are allowing the devices connected to IoT and NoT networks to access my main and test Home Assistant servers. Then I created two drop rules doing the following. If a device connected to my IoT or NoT networks wants to access my main network, and if this doesn't meet any of these allow rules, then drop this attempt. If you have any casting-enabled devices like Chromecast, Apple TVs and so on, you probably have to add dedicated allow rules for their specific ports. That is in order casting and announcing services of these devices to continue to work as expected. With that, my local network configuration in UniFi Dream Machine is complete. So, is it still worth it to buy UniFi Dream Machine now? The short answer is no. Especially if at the time of watching this video, the UniFi Dream Router is already on the market. If this is the case, just buy the Dream Router instead. But if you're in a hurry and you can't wait for the UDR to pop, and you want a device that is simple yet powerful enough, also the price is not bothering you, consider buying the Dream Machine, as it is still a very good option. If you are a network guy and you are willing to learn and combine, then check the pfSense alternatives. Having said that, don't forget to subscribe with the notification bell and to like this video if you really do. Follow me on Twitter, join my Discord server, and remember, home smart, but not hard. I'm Kirill, and I'm done speaking. Bye!